loops seem quite easy in Scratch and they're in Python. So can we use what we know about loops from Scratch to help us learn loops in Python? Yes, we can. So we know control blocks in Scratch. We've got repeat, forever. We have if then and if then else. And the loops, we have repeat and forever. So a forever loop in Scratch is like a while loop in Python. So we understand the forever loop, a while loop's similar. But in Scratch we've got a red button, so we can stop the forever loop. But there is no red button in Python. So how does it stop? Well, remember in our if statement we had this condition, like if x is less than 10. That condition we can use in while loops. So a while loop uses a condition. So for example, we've got while 5 is less than 10, print hello. That will continue forever, like a forever loop. But how do you break the loop? Well, what happens if the condition is false? It comes out of the loop. So here we've got while x is less than 10. We print hello and x, and then we add 1. Eventually x will equal 10. It will go from 0 up to 10, and once it reaches 10, obviously it's not less than 10, so it will come out the while loop. The other alternative method is to use break. Here we've got a while loop. Once it reaches the word break, it will break out of the loop. So let's have a look at loops in Scratch. So we can look at our forever loop. Let's create a variable called x. We set x to 0. We're going to change x, and then we're going to say x. So let's start this, and as you see, we run it and the numbers go up by 1. And it keeps going. Let me scratch. This will just keep on going until we press the red button. There's no red button in Python, so we need a way of stopping it. So we said about using this condition. Well, what happens if we change this forever loop until a repeat until? So here we've got a condition saying repeat until, let's say our x is greater than 100. So now when we run this, it's going to give us the numbers the same. Once it reached 101, it stopped. So with our loop forever in Scratch, we can use it because we've got the red button. Python, we haven't. We have to use the condition. In here we've got a condition, we use a repeat until. So the forever loop we can use in Scratch goes forever. In Python we have a similar thing in a while loop, but we have to stop the loop either with the break or a condition, and once that condition is false, then it will come out of the loop. Let's have a look at a while loop in Python. So this is quite similar to forever. Here we've got a loop. It will print hello and x. And x is 0 to start off with, and it will go up by 1. Similar to what we might see in Scratch. If we run that, it will just keep printing hello and a number. It won't stop. And that's not what we want in Python. So you can see here we've had to interrupt. What we need is a condition that will stop the loop. So for example, we can say if x is less than 10. So now when we run it, the program, we say hello and it's gone from 0 to 9. So if we wanted to make that from 1 to 10, we could start off at 1. And while it's less than 11, we run it and you can see It will print hello 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So here we've got the condition, and the loop stops when the condition is false. The repeat loop in Scratch is similar to the for loop in Python. We have repeat and then the number of times we wish to repeat the loop. In Python we have the for loop. It's slightly different. We can use a number, but in Python we put that number in brackets after the word range. So we have here for x in range 10, print hello x. So that will print hello with a number 10 times. Now let's look at our repeat loop. So here we're repeating 10 times. If we use our x value again, we set x, let's start x at 1. And we're going to change x by 1. And we want to say x again. So we can put x in there. We're going to start off by saying x, so it's going to say 1, it's going to change by 1, so x is going to be 2, then 3, then 4, and this will carry on. And we can see when we run this, what happens is we get our numbers from 1 to 10. So when we run this, you can see it goes from 1 to 10 quite quickly, but that's what it does, 1 to 10. So that's quite a straightforward repeat loop in Scratch. That we can see in Python, very similar, is a for loop. So let's have a look in Python. We have more control using a for loop. So if we know how many times we want to go around in a loop, we can certainly use for. So here we're going to use x as a variable in a range. So we want a range for x in range and then 10 times. So we're going to print hello 10 times. We don't need to add x, it's already in there. So here we've got a for loop for x is in range, and it's going to go from 0 to 9, which is a bit strange. So we're going to print x plus 1. So our for loop in a range, we have 10 range 10 times. We're going to go in a for loop 10 times. So we run that and we print hello 1 to 10. Also, in a for loop, you could go through characters. So for example, we've got A, B, C, D, E, F. So we're going to print hello and then the character. So we've got hello, A, B, C, D, E, F. So we've got for, then the variable, then in. And we could use the range before with a number, the same as the repeat loop in Scratch, but also in Python, we can also loop through other objects, such as this is a string, and also we had lists in Scratch, we have lists in Python. We can loop through them as well. Okay, thank you for watching, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. Bye for now.